haters gonna hate, and that is just a reality. Can't do anything about it. What you can do is you can control your response to negative comments and negative people. By you choosing to not embrace social media or develop an intentional strategy, you're giving in to their hate and you're functioning from fear. So we don't want to do that. Instead, it's better to be prepared to know how to deal with negativity than it is to fear it and not deal with anything and not reap potential benefits that you could be missing out on. So today we're going to talk about the four steps for how to respond to negative comments in a way that leaves your brand strong and gives you the opportunity to learn from potential mistakes. Because the reality is, we all make mistakes. And another reality is, no one's perfect. So let's learn from it. First one, three parts. Don't panic, don't rush, and don't delay. I know they sound contradictory, but hear me out. With don't panic, when you see that first negative comment or that first negative review, you're gonna be in shock and you're gonna go into that fear mode. Oh my, what do I do? How do I handle this? What's my response supposed to be? And you're gonna have the immediate emotional reaction. And that is what we don't want. That is why we don't rush. You need to come down out of that state of shock before you can actually respond in a way that is beneficial to you as a person and beneficial to your business. Don't delay. You have a reasonable amount of time. You want to respond ideally that same day, I'll say within 12 hours max,
to that comment.
Otherwise, you're sending the message of, they're right and I don't care. And you know as well as I do, that's not true. Most likely it was a miscommunication or something happened that wasn't supposed to happen. It was an honest mistake. So we want to address these issues, and we also want to address them in a way that when other people read this review or read this comment, that they get it. So a common approach to handling these comments, usually done by larger companies, is to simply post, I'm sorry for the experience you had, call our customer service reps and we'll take care of it. Okay, you can do that. But there's a slight problem with how that's handled. And that problem is it doesn't tell the next viewer how or even if that problem was resolved. So there needs to be a balance of both, an actual written explanation and the personal interaction with the actual client that had the bad experience. So step one was don't panic, don't rush, and don't delay. Step two is write your message in Word or Notepad or some other source. The simple reason for this is you don't want to accidentally hit reply before your message has been refined. We've all done it. We've hit enter and we've sent an email or we sent a message before it was supposed to. Or if you see the animated memes that are online that show how a boyfriend or a husband responds to his wife and then he deletes it. You don't want to accidentally hit that enter button. So make sure you type it in another program that will completely protect you from that. Once you write it, take a step back. Go for a walk around the office, go for a walk around the block, take a step back, come back and read it.
Does it remove emotion?
Does it acknowledge the original poster's emotions
and situation?
Does it address blatant lies that need to be addressed?
And does it acknowledge
that you could have made a mistake?
And finally, ask
them for a follow-up via phone call, because ultimately we still need to have that personal interaction. If it meets all that criteria, You then want to take your response and send it to somebody that you trust.
Let them know,
hey, I got this negative comment or this negative feedback online and I really want to address it, but I want to make sure I'm not responding emotionally. Can you review it and make
whatever changes, whatever suggestions
you think need to be made before I post it? Thank you.
They make their changes, they send it back to you, you read it again.
And when you're confident that it meets all that criteria and that you're not responding in an emotional, hasty manner, then it's time for you to post
it on the site.
Whatever site that is, whether it be Facebook, LinkedIn, or Yelp, or whatever review site you're using.
The process is all the same. Step three is send it to somebody you know. So real quick review
on the steps. We have step one is don't panic, don't rush, don't delay. Step two is write your message in Word or a third party resource so you don't accidentally respond before your message is ready. Step three is send it to someone you trust to get honest feedback.
And step four is
follow up accordingly. If you've asked them to call you, make sure you have the appropriate systems and notifications in place that regardless of who answers the phone, they are going to be able to deal with the issue or instantly get the person who's having a problem to the right person.
Or if it's you who are supposed to
follow up with them, make sure you do that within 24 hours. Again, the sooner the better to follow up, but also make sure you're not doing it from an emotional state because that's going to hurt them, it's going to hurt their feelings, it's also going to potentially hurt your business.
And take responsibility. So you don't actually need to
fear
the haters or the negative comments. And I got a story that I'll
share with you of a client that I worked with.
He relied heavily
on a site to get
leads for his business. Had a 5-star rating,
fabulous. Everybody loved him. I got a panic call one morning because somebody had done just this. They wrote a scathing,
inappropriate review about his company, and he had no clue what to do. He said, I know who the woman is.
I remember it crystal clear. It did not happen the way she said, and I don't know what to do. I know reviews are heavily regarded on this site, and I'm afraid it's going to put me out of business. And rightfully so. You get that one right review that is bad, it can do a lot of damage. Look what's going on with a certain airline right now. Although that's not an online review, that's just an overall bad experience. Not one, but a couple, but hey, that's a topic for another day. So back to the review. So he sent me the review and I looked at it. And now I knew how his company worked because I'd worked with him before. And so what I did is I wrote him a response.
And we did the exact steps that
I just shared with you.
We were concise, we stayed positive, we addressed her emotions, we apologized for the situation,
we
specifically addressed
what were blatant lies, though we never called them blatant lies.
We took responsibility for
where we could have made mistakes,
and also explained
why we were confident that certain aspects of her bad review did not happen, and we explained the protocol that was established within the company.
We offered to do a follow-up. We
offered to go out and meet with her again, all to attempt to make this right.
She offered to follow up on the phone call
with him, but not offer to do business with him, which is fine.
What has happened since
is because that comment was posted publicly as a reply to her initial complaint.
To this day, he has
landed more business from that negative comment
than he has generated from
any other type of business that he has, or any other type of marketing that he has done for his business.
That's pretty amazing.
And
he's been specifically told by new
clients that they chose
to work with him because of how
he responded. It provided confidence to them that he takes appropriate action. He takes responsibility, and he's willing to own up to his mistakes and fix them if something goes wrong.
That's a pretty powerful statement. And to be able to say that this
one bad review has generated more business for him than any other marketing he's ever done in the entire time he's owned his business, that's also pretty powerful.
So the haters are going to hate. Let them hate, but don't let it hold you down with fear. Alrighty, post your comments and questions below, and I'm happy to interact with you, and let me know what other thoughts you have about negativity online and what challenges or fears you're facing about it, or you've heard of, because we don't have any fears, right?
Awesome. Okay, I'll talk to you guys soon.